From ordinary to extraordinary. From ordinary to extraordinary. That's how somebody is going to be manifesting from the Lord. From ordinary to extraordinary. In the book of Exodus chapter 4, verse 2, then you cannot go to maybe like 20. You see that he called something the rod of Moses. But later, the man started calling the same thing the rod of God. What happened? The ordinary had turned to extraordinary. And the Lord said unto him, what is that in thy hand? And he said, a rod, just a rod. And he goes to 20. And Moses took his wife and his sons and set them upon an ass, and he returned to the land of Egypt. And Moses took what?
The rod of God.
The rod of God in his hand. It's amazing. It's not a different rod. The same rod that had been his rod, that God was asking, what is in your hand? A rod. Just an ordinary rod. But between that time that God was asking and the time that he was to go back and confront Pharaoh, that rod had been transformed. That is what we call miraculous transformation. There is somebody here. Your life is going to be experiencing miraculous transformation.
Amen.
Miraculous transformation is the power of God coming upon a thing. And the thing will not change in look, but in function, in manifestation, there will be changes. Something that was not bringing result before will now start bringing awesome result. How does that kind of thing happen? Because by looking at the rod, it's the same. But the work of the rod has changed. People sometimes will look at some people's life. But look at some people physically. This is the girl that I used to know. This is the girl that I used to know. This is the lady or woman that I used to know. But they don't know that something has been added to the equation that the person is no longer as they used to know. I prophesy into your life. In any area you have been operating ordinarily, that they don't beat you, they don't even look at you twice, or they don't even consider your words twice. From today, let the power of God come upon your life.
Amen.
So that in that same area, you will be attracting great attention in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
What makes this to happen? When God is added to a thing, it stops being ordinary. The addition of God unto anything makes that thing to stop being ordinary. It was when God started speaking concerning that rod. Moses has been carrying that rod, he will throw it anywhere at any time. But because God spoke concerning the rod, by virtue of God speaking concerning the rod, the power of God entered into that rod. And it stopped. When God speaks concerning a thing, all attention in heaven will be addressed towards that thing. It happened concerning blind Bartimaeus. He was neglected. His word was not even considered. But there was a time he was even shouting after Jesus Christ. He told him to keep short. But the Bible said in that Mark chapter 10, I think 46, Mark 10, 46. The Bible said when Jesus Christ heard him, he stood still and commanded him to be called. And by, can you give me 48? 48, give me 48. And many charged him that he should hold his peace, but he cried the more a great deal, thou son of David. He did not want to hear his voice, but 49 now. Now look at 49. And Jesus stood still and commanded him to be called, and see what happened after. The people that were telling him to keep short, because God has spoken concerning him, all attention just went unto him. And they called the blind man, saying unto him, be of what?
Good comfort.
Rise, he calleth thee. the attention now focused on him favorably. This amount of favor, you shall receive your favor.
Amen.
In any area of your life that you have been despised, favor is coming your way.
Amen.
Somebody once spoke on this altar, I think sometime last year, that the pot at the wedding of that Cana of Galilee was neglected. It was not even considered. But it was when Jesus Christ spoke concerning it that they should go and fetch water, all attention just went from even the people that are doing wedding, went to the pot of water. Because it has been spoken concerning. Have you been abandoned or neglected in any area of your life? Nothing much is happening. That is neglect. But from today, God's attention is coming upon your life.
Amen.
I said that God's attention is coming upon your
Amen.
Life.
Amen.
What makes ordinary to be extraordinary is God being added to it. Yet, you will not see any change physically in the person or in the thing, but the manifestation will have changed. Why? Because God is not physical. God being with a person is not physical. So the illusion is that it's the same person, but you may not be able to see at the addition in the realm of the spirit that it's not the same person. There is already a power, awesome power, that is accompanying this person around. And with that awesome power, nothing will be impossible for the person. Mark chapter 10, 27, the Bible says that with men, it shall be impossible, but not with God, for with God, how many things?
All things.
Whatever you have been trusting God for, let the Almighty God rest upon your life, His hand.
Amen.
And let there be possibility unto His glory.
Amen.
And to your blessing.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The rod of Moses became the rod of God, because God has been added to it. When God is involved in your affair, nothing is impossible. There is nothing you cannot achieve. The people that have seen you as no big deal, they will start seeing you as somebody that is worthy of knowing, worthy of listening to. That one has happened to me on different occasions. In different way, and it will yet happen the more.
Amen.
I even know. I'm prophesying into your own life. The people that have disregarded you, they will come and bow to you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Those God can just be there. Just do all you can do to just involve God in your affairs or to attract God into that ordinary thing. Don't decide anything, because it is the addition of God in anything that makes anything to be ordinary. We have said it many times here that there is no extraordinary person in my own consideration, no extraordinary ministry. It is the involvement of the extraordinary God that makes any person appear extraordinary. Once God is removed from the person, immediately God was removed from the life of King Saul, he started misbehaving. To the extent of even wanting to kill somebody that God was using, who now wanted to kill somebody else. Because the Bible says that, and God has departed from me. And the spirit, the evil spirit now came into his life. I prophesy to your life that God will not depart from you. The Lord Almighty shall not depart from you. In the name of Jesus. There is this story of the soldier. And that soldier had to be a Christian. He was always witnessing to his other colleague, and they were always making jest of him, because he would not do the things that were not right that he was doing, and he would keep on, you know, witnessing to them. So anytime they saw him, they just be making jest of him. They were trying to fool around with him. One day, I think they were in their command center or something. Their commander also wanted to take his toll on him. And I called him. That only that he could not drive. And now told him to go and repack a military jeep from one place to another. I know in the military, obey the last order. I mean, don't, before you complain or say something, Once you are given an instruction, go and do it anyhow. And the other people, they are just looking, waiting to laugh. Knowing that this guy could not actually try it. And he started going. As he was going, he was just praying, God, please help me. Don't put me to shame. That when you just get here, we just stay inside and do anything. That way, at the end of the day, maybe it will be cosmic. Maybe they will be punished. He did not even care. We were just praying, God, just help me. By the time he entered, he prayed again. And he just turned the ignition. All of a sudden, the deep horizontal cord just started moving. Started moving and move and turn to the point that the commander told him to go and repack. Everybody was just, no, everybody that they were going to laugh, they were just looking and just stopped. When he got to that point, he stopped and he came out. Thank you, Jesus. As he was coming out, approaching them, all those his colleagues that they were waiting to make fun of him, they just went on their knees and started telling him to pray for them. Because they knew that he could not drive. How did it that this God that this guy had been talking about, and as he was still amazed, the commander that gave him the instruction, tears were coming down his cheeks. He was not wondering what happened. Other people were wondering. He said that, you know, I now believe that you serve a God that is living, that you have been telling us. Because actually, I just wanted to make fun of you and nothing more. Because I've already told them to remove the engine of that jeep for something a day before, which is unknown. Meaning that there was no engine in that jeep. How did the thing now move? I prophesy into your own life. All the people that are waiting to make fun or jest of you, they will come and bow. Yeah. On the day of your celebration, ordinary can become extraordinary when God is involved in it. Just God speaking concerning a thing turns that thing to extraordinary. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, speak concerning my life right now. In the name of Jesus, speak. You may not hear his voice in the realm of the spirit, but when he speaks concerning a thing, there is change. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
When Jesus Christ spoke concerning the bread and the fish of that little boy, it changed. Even though it was still like ordinary to them, but the manifestation became extraordinary. The involvement of God in anything turns that thing around. I've told us of the case of a medical student many times that she had to take that examination. Maximum time is 3 times. If you fail the 3 times, that will be the end. And she took the first time, she failed. The second time, she failed. The third time, they were even telling her to relax. She was still crying and left. But she prayed, she was fasting, she was doing everything to go and take this examination. At the last time, and she was praying, God, please help me, pray for me. And the kind of examination is not written per se, practical, because you enter into a particular place that panel will be sitting, and you'll be asked any question in the medical field, and there will be a physical sample or a patient, a mock patient that will be lying. And you say that if this kind of something is happening to a person and it rushed into your hospital, what will you do? Those kind of things. And by the time she was to enter the place, the people before her, they were just crying, meaning that they had not been favored. She was still trying to ask somebody, what did they ask you? And the thing is that they might not even ask the same question. But you know, she just wanted to, in case, they just told her next, and she entered. By the time she entered, they asked her a question that appeared as if they were speaking in tongues, in the sense that she had no idea. With all her reading and all, she had never heard that kind of thing before. And she didn't want to say, I just don't know like that. And she just went there to the patient. In fact, if she even had said she did not know, they would even have a very bad image concerning her and just tell her to just go. And that would be the final time. She would never be able to go beyond that place. I don't know how to do it in their field. And she went to the patient. and she was looking, she was trying to think, what did he say about this thing? Could it be the head side? Could it be the knee side? Could it? No, she was just there and they were looking at her. And after a while, she now went to the wrist of the mock patient that was lying down. She wanted to check the time because they always give you, I think, about 5 minutes, 3 to 5 minutes to check the time. That let time couldn't go and let them just tell me that I feel. By the time she was taking off the wrist, one of the professors that was sitting down there said that, yes, that is it, that is it, that is it. All the fool that have been coming here, they don't know that it's pulse that you should check first. It's pulse, they don't know, but they gave her the answer. God help her, because she had been calling on God, that God please help her. She did not even know how God would do it. In fact, when God was doing it, she was thinking that it was her last trial. Are you confused that something that's happening in your life, that you don't even know how God would do it? God will step into the situation and turn the ordinary to extraordinary. I said, God will turn the ordinary to extraordinary. Once God is involved in a thing, little things becomes much when God is involved in it. The rod of Moses now became the rod of God. It got to a time that God, Moses told Joshua to go down. I think that should be Exodus chapter 17. Exodus 17, 9 to around 11. Told Joshua to go down and be fighting. And he lifted up his hand. The hand that he had been using all this while. But by the lifting, anybody can lift up hand. But this lifting of hand was different from the other one he had been lifting up all this while. Because God was involved in it. Lift up your hand and say, Father,
every battle of my life,
in the similitude of Moses, as I lift up my hand, fight for me and give me the victory. In the name of Jesus, any area of my life that I'm struggling, that I'm fighting, that I'm panting, as I'm lifting up my hand right now, just like Moses lifted up the hand. In Jesus' mighty name, we all pray. Say, Father, let your anointing come upon every ordinary thing in my life and turn it to extraordinary now. Let your anointing come upon every ordinary thing and turn it to extraordinary. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
We said, whenever God speaks concerning a thing, all the attention of heaven will just be addressed toward that thing. He spoke concerning Brother Bartimaeus, everybody's attention now goes to him. He spoke concerning the box that was filled with water. All the attention of heaven and power went into it to transform it. He spoke concerning the water that Peter had been toiling all night. He said, I'm not charging to that particular day. All the attention of heaven just came. All fishes quickly come home because the man has already spoken concerning that. There must not be disappointment or concerning the word of the master. I prophesy into your life. Every word that has been spoken concerning, especially this month, we have been told that this is your time of favor.
Amen.
We have been told that victorious grace is your portion.
Amen.
Let there be manifestation in your life. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When God speaks concerning a thing, all the attention of heaven and resources in heaven will just be addressed towards that thing. He speaks and it is done. Even if that thing was not there, maybe fishes were not there, miraculously, they will not be created because it's a creator. Because his word will not come to the ground, without accomplishing that which he has sent it for. Has God spoken concerning you in any area of your life and you are yet to see the manifestation? Get set before the end of this week.
Amen.
Manifestation will come in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Concerning a womb that has never known a man like Mary. You don't know God. The word of God is powerful. It's beyond medical terms. It's beyond economy. If he says that by this time tomorrow, I'm prophesying into your life, in any area that you need any assistance, any manifestation of God's glory, let there be divine attention on you. In the name of Jesus. Final prayer, say, Father, in my life today, that we call all to know that have a God in heaven. Do something tonight, today, that we cause all to know that there shall be God in heaven. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Father, thank you because you have made it clear to us that you can turn ordinary to extraordinary. Sometimes we look at what is in our hand. It's so ordinary. The little thing. Will it be able to be okay? But there is nothing that cannot be extraordinary when you come into it. Please come into every ordinary thing in our life.
Yeah.
And let your name be glorified.
Yeah.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you,
in Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.